Ooh.
What's up, guys? Retro Reflex. We're back for part two of Red Dead Redemption. Red Dead Redemption 1.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now, where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase.
Yeah, eh? Hello.
Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished, bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Change is only good when it makes things better. That's the barn over there. Paul built it himself when I was just a little girl.
Whoa there.
And here we are, back at the house. Let's stop for a while before we head out on patrol.
That was in patrol.
No complaint from me, Miss McFarland.
Come in. Can you bite?
How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Thank
you, ma'am. Getting shot then riding a horse seems to take it out of you.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house and then you can sit for a while.
Miss McFarland.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening?
Sure.
I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
It's a fine weapon.
It is.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time. We'd best get moving. This is a dangerous time of night for us.
Hoping the new red.
Follow me. Keep your eyes peeled for anything suspicious.
Hoping the new Red Dead game you can make your own like town or something like that, you know, like have different like properties and stuff. That'd be so cool.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team.
Come on.
Look, those damn rabbits are at the crops again. Get down and give me a hand, will you? Come on, then. Time to put that bloodlust of yours to good use.
Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Mr. Marston. Looks like we'll be having rabbit stew tomorrow. Let's mount up and patrol the rest of the property.
Oops.
We should keep moving. There's still a ways to go. Stealing our cattle, it's the rabbits stealing our crops.
It ain't never easy living off the land like this. Maybe you should move to a big city, become a
Yeah, man. Fuck is in the coyote. I mean, the coyote's in the fucking rabbits, eh? Chickens?
You know, you can actually handle
a man.
It's something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe Bill Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland.
Oh, my stomach. Is that golden? Or is that just the lighting? Have to get that. Let's sleep eyes. Oh, you can move fast. Obstacles in a path.
Oh, Mr. Marston. How are you doing today?
I'm well, Miss McFarland. Thank you. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Thank you. So, how are your ribs?
Fine. A little sore, but apart from a couple extra scars, it'll be as nothing happened.
Good. Come in. You know, you never did tell me how you met that Bill Williamson, what you wanted from him.
No, miss, I did not.
Well, why not, if you don't mind me asking?
I certainly don't mind you asking if you don't mind me not telling. See, it's a complicated and somewhat pathetic tale, and by telling you, not only will I be putting your life in danger, but also threatening the lives of some people that I hold very dear.
Well, I apologize if I seem to be prying.
And I apologize for my reticence. Hope you believe me when I say that it's simply out of respect for you.
Of course, Mr. Marston. I understand that a city dweller such as yourself likes to have some exotic secrets, so us country folk are impressed.
I'm no city man, miss.
Yeah, but I saw you get on the train at Blackwater. You with those gentlemen in bowler hats?
I'm still no city man.
But I bet you can't ride, Mr. Marston.
I hate to take money from a lady, miss.
Oh, you won't be. I'll race you right now.
If it makes you happy.
We'll see.
She trying to get slapped up? Yo.
All right, I'll show you how we ride around these parts.
Yeah.
Key up.
Go.
I wish you there, huh?
on the count of three. Three, two, one, go! I trust you're not gonna be a gentleman about this!
Oh, fuck. My bad, dude. It's a real thing. Oh! Fuck. I might have lost. Fuck. I think they'll make it so I catch up with her though. Say what?
Come on. Let's go, Miss McFarland.
I'm coming, don't you worry.
Oh no. Fuck.
Neck and neck, Miss McFarland.
Yeah.
Call yourself a rancher? I bet you're starting to regret your brave words, Miss McFarland. Let's go.
Yeah.
How you doing back there?
She's lucky I fell off my horse. Winners! Oh wait, what? No! I went the wrong way! Oh my god! Oh my god! No! I can't believe I lost. I mean, I want to do this mission since it's right here.
Ah, Mr. Marston, how are you?
Good, Miss McFarland. How are you?
I'm well. Would you mind riding with me to Armadillo? I've got to get some supplies and I could do with the company.
Of course.
You can take the reins. It wouldn't do for a terrifying bounty hunter such as yourself to be seen driven around by a woman. Take the driver's seat. Come on.
Do you have to hold Y?
You're looking much better, considering you were almost buzzard food a couple days ago.
I have you to thank for that, miss.
So do tell me, have you needlessly ruined your life since we last spoke?
No, miss, I have not.
Well, that's a relief. Perhaps there's hope for you yet.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Oh, there's always hope, Mr. Marston. You can't be a rancher in this kind of country if you don't believe that.
An admirable attitude, miss.
I suppose so. I can't think of any...
I can't always say I do either.
Oh, don't be so deliberately enigmatic.
I'm not, miss.
Yes, you are. You are being deliberately obscure as a substitute for having a personality.
I just know there are two theories to arguing with women, and neither one works.
I'm not even going to dignify that gibberish with a response.
Sorry.
I think it's kind of funny I found you dying on the side of the road and now you're driving me into town.
You have a strange sense of humor.
Well, you must admit, it's an unusual start to a friendship.
I didn't realize we were friends, Miss McFarland.
Oh, please. Now who's being funny? Listen, I know that business with Williamson is your business, but I don't know. You've been good to us, and I don't think you're a bad man. Stupid, perhaps, but not rotten. I just worry about you gallivanting around these parts like you're some kind of deranged bounty hunter. Like Paul always says, don't go waking snakes.
I appreciate your concern for us lesser mortals, Miss McFarland. I really do. And if there was any other way out, I'd take it. I can assure you of that.
I think we best stick to the road.
I have a small holding up in Great Plains.
A farmer? Yeah. Don't leave the reins. And at what point during your day of hunting down outlaws do you find time to raise chickens?
Only been at it 3 years or so. I guess I'm kind of new to it.
You're telling me. So who's looking after this farm of yours right now?
Uncle. Well, he's not my uncle, as far as I know. Just an old dog who's as lazy as a lizard on a hot day. Kind of fella laboring under the delusion that age brings wisdom.
Sounds like the perfect person to leave in charge of your entire livelihood.
That could be anywhere, huh? Oh, did I get it? Guess I did. Fuck is shooting, bro? This guy's not shooting me. What are you talking about? Yo, I broke the lock. Get the fuck out of here.
It's kinda funny I found you dying. Oh my.
Get the fuck out of here. Wait, what? Okay guys, I'll be right back in the next episode. Good time to cut. That was some bullshit. I'll meet you.